Grace, mercy, and peace to all the saints of God's church from God our Father and the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Where to begin? When we consider the lives of the saints of God, where to begin? We think of people who have changed the world because of their walk of faith with the Lord. We think of people from the beginning of time when our oldest memories stretch back to Abraham and Sarah, beyond them to those who walked by faith in the earliest days of creation. We think of people like David, who was raised up from a boy out in the fields to be king over Israel, whose life was never exactly one of good behavior, but was always one marked with songs and prayers of deep faith. Where to begin? Consider people of the New Testament who met Jesus in a way that we might wish had been our own, who looked at him eye to eye in that holy incarnation, who held his hands and were held by his, who were healed and restored and fed and encouraged and befriended. We think how a woman caught in the very act of adultery became a witness to mercy that refused to throw stones. We think of a young man who lay on his own bier in a shroud of death, who heard the words, "Sit up, climb down, and walk back to your mother, and be a family where a family needs to be." We think of disciples who never understood what Jesus was talking about, but knew he was always with them. Disciples who were welcomed to be back with him, even when they hid and locked their doors and turned away. Where to begin? In a world where we have histories of people like Francis, who takes all his money, all his wealth, all his privilege, and sells it away to walk on earth preaching to bees and to birds about God Creator. Where to begin when we consider the reformers of the church who risked life and limb to point to a gospel that they didn't get right because they knew it, but a gospel in which they walked faithfully because they trusted the Lord would never leave them? Where do we begin with saints lifted up in our own lifetimes? The big names like Teresa of Calcutta, St. John Paul II, who growing up as a boy in war-torn Poland couldn't imagine the word peace he would bring to a world, the word of freedom he would bring to a world that was so politically divided with curtains made of iron. I think probably most of us begin with someone like Grandpa or our Sunday school. Most of us begin with that couple that lived across the street that welcomed us in like part of their own family and loved us. Most of us begin with the choir director who taught us to sing songs of Jesus' love. Most of us begin with camp counselors who woke up early in the morning to take us outside and show us in the needle of a pine tree that this life matters, and that there is a God behind it who desires for something to exist out of nothing. Many of us remember pastors who sat with us in our childhood, teaching us how to receive God's presence, a presence we may have first received unknowingly in the waters of baptism, but then a presence that we held in our hands as bread and wine carry the promise, "My body, my blood, given and shed for you." You might remember the church secretaries who called us, asking us if we would read lessons or polish silver. We remember men and women who have sat in these pews with us, some of them a long time ago, some of them very recently, who showed us through the witness of their lives that to be a Christian is not to have things easy and not to have things figured out, but to walk in faith with the God who walks with us so much that the time may come when we shut our eyes and entrust ourselves to the arms of a Jesus that we long to have seen in a way that would be clearly visible. And yet it's a Jesus who promises to hold us when we awake in a glory that is as mysterious as a needle on a pine tree. Where do we begin? God looks on this church, not just this church in its grand glorious, one holy Catholic apostolic ways, but God looks on this church at St. Mark and looks at the lives of you who gather, who break bread with one another and pass the peace with each other, who sing hymns that you know well and love deeply, loudly, and sing hymns that are new and unfamiliar, with a certain amount of reserve, but still to the glory of God. God looks on you in the generosity of your time and of your prayers. How you take home a prayer list full of strangers, and you lift them up not because you know who they are, but because you know they are deeply beloved to someone who shares this holy space. Where to begin? Currently, we have one member expecting a little one in the near future who knows how many more little ones are waiting to come join us. Who knows how many lives have not yet been conceived, but will be shaped by words of grace and love that they learn from you. Children will grow up in this world knowing that elections on Tuesday can't rip and tear them apart because they have a God who looks on them with such love that the only thing that blossoms and grows is a beautiful rose of faith. Faith that God has to us that allows us to be saints. And who knows how many saints are wandering this earth right now? They may be families in the military, preparing to be shipped out to Virginia. They know no one here, and they will need us to welcome and love them. Who knows what poor decisions are being made right now at this very minute that will lead some stranger into the halls of Nottoway, waiting for a prison ministry to bring them good news of a God who's found in bread and wine alongside the prophets. Who knows what neighbor in our midst has always needed to know that there is a God of beauty and power and love, but was never introduced to it until she met people who knew that God at a holiday bazaar, or he met people who could ring out that God's joy at a bell concert. Where do we begin? On this day of All Saints, we hold in our hearts those who have gone before us and those who stand with us around the world. We are poured into and out of the same baptism. We hear them ring out in our midst when we kneel to receive Christ's presence in communion. But where do we begin on this Feast of All Saints? You know where God begins. God begins with the love that is poured out for you to go and set the captive. God begins with the word of grace and mercy that has been entrusted to you, that you can go out to your neighbors with the confidence and power of Jesus Christ and say to your friends, come to me, you who are weary and heavy laden, so that you can say to your opponents, I will give you rest. Take on you the yoke that we have received as God's saints, and learn from us, because if there's anything we know, it's that we have been made humble. By God's grace, we've been given gentle hearts. Learn from us. We get to teach the world that God's yoke is easy and God's burden is light. When we grow up together in the blossom, in the life and the love that God has given to be our way of life with all the saints.